Tech Review. We've got magic to do just for you. We've got miracle plays to play. We've got parts to perform, hearts to warm, kings and things to take by storm as we go along our way.
For your entertainment pleasure, we bring to you our most mysterious and miraculous of tales, a stunning example of
magic
and merriment.
You will witness acts of
lust,
murder,
holy war,
and a climax. Ladies and gentlemen, a climax never before seen on a public stage.
Not now, later.
Sorry.
Our tale today concerns the firstborn son of Charlemagne and is entitled... But before we begin, let me assure you that what you are about to see is the true life story of Pippin. You see, there have been many misconceptions about Pippin. One, that he was...
a hunchback.
Or that he was...
enormously tall.
Or that he was...
a midget.
Or even that he was...
completely bald by the age of 14.
But I beg you, please cast all previous misconceptions aside and accept what we enact for you today. The life of Pippin begins. Pippin as a child showed tremendous thirst for knowledge. As a result, the years went by quickly. Charlemagne sent Pippin to the University of Padua.
And the faculty of the university presented him the special title of Scholar of the House.
Pippin replied to this offer in his own deeply moving words. He might be a little nervous. This is his first time playing this part. Could I have some more lights, please?
He's not that nervous.
Thank you. Gentle tutors, respected members of the faculty, I'm very grateful for the knowledge that you have given me. But I'm afraid what I'm looking for can't be found in books. I'm not exactly sure what I want to do or where I want to go. Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Every man has his daydreams, every man has his goals. People like the way dreams have a sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning, nightingales have their song. I want my life to be something more than love. Rivers belong, they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Rest until I know I'll have it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I'm gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run. I promise not to waste my life in commonplace, ordinary pursuits.
Terrific.
You see, I know there is something...
Something fulfilling? Completely fulfilling?
Yes, that's it. Something completely fulfilling.
Oh, fantastic.
And I'm going to find it.
Journey, journey to a spot exciting, mystic and exotic. Journey through an exotic
of Charles the Great. The first day I was home from Padua, my father sent me a horse. The second day he sent me a falcon. On the third day I went hunting, and on the fourth day my father finally came himself.
Enter Charlemagne. This part is to be portrayed by an actor of enormous power. A giant on the battlefield and in the bedroom.
Uh-huh. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Well, welcome home, son. Well, hello, son.
Hello. You look thinner. I know. So, son. So. Last night, didn't you miss dinner?
No.
Oh. Well, how did things go in Padua?
Very well, sir. Some of my tutors told me
good,
my last
good.
Class.
I am a great believer in education.
And yet you have become the most powerful man in the world without it.
The most powerful man in the world? Oh, Pippin, don't exaggerate. What about the Pope?
I rank you ahead of the Pope, sir.
I happen to agree with you. But in my day, the world was simpler. The sword solved every problem. The future belongs to you.
But it's still today.
But for how long? Sunrise and sunset are similar, but not identical.
Enter Lewis. Pippin's half-brother. And after Pippin, heir to the throne. Addicted to the physical, Lewis loves wrestling. Lewis loves weightlifting, but most of all, Lewis loves Lewis.
Well done, brother.
Well done. That was magnificent. Did you know that this is the arm that slew 20 Phrygians last year? And it's going to slay even more Visigoths.
You mean you're going to war against the Visigoths?
Uh-huh. That's the next one. It's going to be a glorious campaign. And oh, those Visigoth women. Oh, I didn't mean to shock your bookish sensibilities.
I'm only shocked that you're interested in women now.
Enter Fastrada. Pippin's stepmother. Devious. Crafty. Cunning, untrustworthy, but a warm and wonderful mother dedicated to gaining the throne for her darling son, Lewis.
Lewis!
Oh, mommy!
Darling! Oh, baby! Lewis, look what mommy has for you!
Oh,
it's so pretty! Oh.
Look at that! Oh, it's gold, and it's silver, and it's bronze. Look at how strong as I can use in battle against the Visigoths. This is so great! Pippin, look at it! Isn't it beautiful?
It really is beautiful.
Uh-huh.
Oh, darling. Oh, welcome home, Pippin.
Can you imagine how it'll shine in the sun?
Oh, Pippin, you do look darling. Beautiful, beautiful, darling. Doesn't he look beautiful, Pippin? Pippin, stand up straight. Didn't they teach you posture in Padua?
I failed posture.
Look at Lewis. Look how straight Lewis stands.
Oh, yes, he's a real straight stander. No question about that.
Look how I shine! Ha! 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 Visigoths.
Dear, before I forget, the royal treasurer has informed me that I have overdrawn my allowance account again.
You're overdrawn again?
Darling, don't be angry with me, please. You know how confused I get about money. After all, I'm just an ordinary housewife and mother. Just like all you housewives and mothers out there.
You know, sometimes I wonder if the fornicating I'm getting is worth the fornicating I'm getting. Well, son, now we can have our talk. How are you doing?
Well, not very well. Father, there were a lot of problems in my
life. Welcome home, son, welcome home. I'm so glad to hear there's nothing wrong. Welcome home, son, glad you're home. Will you be staying long?
Well, that's what I wanted to talk to you about, Father. I wanted to ask if it was okay if
welcome
I had my
little home, room. Son. Welcome home. I've got to go. It's almost noon.
But, Father!
Welcome home, son. Glad you're home.
I wanted to talk.
We'll talk again soon.
Pippin, while you're here, why don't you keep busy?
Take that falcon and horse I gave you and go hunting.
Good idea. Thank you, sir.
Oh, Pip.
Yes, sir?
One more thought I would impart is, I may blush, but I'll be frank.
Do, sir.
Home is where the heart is. Why did I say that?
Thank you, sir.
Why did he say that?
Preparations for the Visigoths' campaign were reaching a peak. Mark's men tested themselves against the Butts. Sword's men tested themselves against each other. The panoply of war was being assembled. The sights and sounds of glory were in the air.
Glory!
Glory! Glory! Glory! Glory! Glory's in the air, and what am I doing?
Nothing.
Your sword, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were a warrior.
No, wait, I'll take it.
But you're not one of us.
I'm Prince Pippin.
Who?
Prince Pippin! One day I will be king.
Oh.
Ha! Visigoths!
I think I'm going to go talk to my father.
The royal court of Charles the Great, Emperor of the Holy Roman Empire...
And a giant in the bedroom!
And a giant in the bedroom... is now prepared to hear petitions.
O great leader, blessed by God, sent to us to protect us from the infidel.
Oh, what is it?
Sire, I beseech you to reduce my levy of foot soldiers, cattle, and wheat due to a famine.
Denied. Next.
But, sire, my cattle are dying and my fields are barren.
Denied. Next.
Sire, that is unjust and tyrannical.
Whoops.
Take that man away and hang him. Next.
Oh, great leader, blessed by God, sent to us from heaven.
Oh, no, not all that bullshit again. Out, out, everybody out. Council is dismissed.
Wait, father.
Yes.
I know what I want to do now.
Good, good.
I want to be a soldier.
What?
Yes, I want to join you in your campaign against the Visigoths.
Denied.
But that's not fair.
To an emperor, fairness is irrelevant.
You're taking Louis.
Well, Louis is an excellent soldier. He's strong. And stupid. You, on the other hand, are educated.
But I'm your oldest son. That means I might be king one day, and fighting wars is an important part of being king, isn't it?
Fighting wars is the most important part of being king. Why, the Pope and I have dedicated ourselves to bringing Christianity to the whole world, no matter how many people we have to kill to do it.
But that's what I'm talking about. You're dedicated to something, and I just want to be dedicated to something, too, with all my heart and soul. And whatever it is, I want to do it as well as I possibly can.
That's a really nice thought.
Thank you. Otherwise, my life won't have any meaning at all.
You want your life to have meaning, do you?
Yes, I do.
That's very ambitious of you, Pippin.
Father! Stop all this bullshit and take me with you!
Ho, ho, ho! All right, get yourself a decent helmet and come along.
I'm a soldier?
Right.
Me a warrior! Finally a chance to be a part of something important. A chance to use my sword, my arm, and maybe even my blood.
Glory!
Glory!
Thank you.
been a long, hard march, and this is where we are, here. And tomorrow morning at sunrise, we march against the Visigoths.
Ha! Visigoths!
Pippin, sit down. Now, the most important part of tomorrow's battle is the terrain. So look at this map. Study it. Remember it.
Father, why can't we just go out there and slaughter them?
Yep.
Pippin, you spoke?
Since we're braver and stronger and have God on our side, can't we just go out there and kill at will?
Do not!
Pippin, war is a science.
That takes half the fun out of it right there.
There's lots of fun when you win. War is a science with rules to be applied.
Yeah!
Which good soldiers appreciate, record and recapitulate.
Ha!
Before they go to decimate the others. Got to get them down here, and this is how we will. Our men in the ravine, that's his area in green, will move across the valley where they plainly can be seen, and the enemy in blue will undoubtedly pursue, for that's what you depend upon an enemy to do. Then to guarantee their folly, we'll bring bowmen into play, who will fire just one volley and retire to point A. And then
the men
go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Hark, the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilations, we can hear a grateful nation's cheers.
Pippin, sit down immediately.
Sorry, Father, just got carried away.
Now, where was I? Ah, yes. War is a science, a breeding ground for brains.
Ha-cha!
Although I cannot write my name, the men whose pens have brought them fame write endless paragraphs explaining my campaign. Meet us at a point of labeled B, and their bowmen on the hill in yellow on the map. We'll leave the post and join the rest and fall into our trap. Then we'll cut off reinforcements and retreat of any kind, bearing principles of inflated mind. And if all the ploys we've picked to really work to bring to pass occur, we won't have just a victory, we'll have ourselves a massacre. And then
the men
go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Hark, the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilations, we can hear a grateful nation's
pippin!
I'm sorry, it won't happen again.
Now listen to me closely, I'll endeavor to explain. We'll separate the charlatan from a Charlemagne. A rule confessed by generals, illustrious and merit, pompous as a popping horse, sharing of the day. Simple rule that every great man knows by heart. It's smarter to be lucky than it's lucky to be smart. And if the fates feel frivolous, and all our plans they smother, but suppose this war does shrivel us, there'll always be another. And gentlemen, and then. Now, gentlemen, now.
And then the men.
Pippin, I find your attitude most distressing.
I'm sorry, Father, it's just all that talk about enfilade and defilade.
But you have to remember that the Visigoth king across the valley, he's talking about enfilade and defilade as well. That's how it's done.
I'll know better next time.
I certainly hope so. There's just one more thing. The night before battle, I always like to pray. I would like my two sons to join me. O God, we who fight in your name and in the name of your Son, pray for victory in battle tomorrow.
Father, is the Visigoth king praying for victory too?
Oh yes, old King Alec, he's one of the best prayers in the business. Lewis, Pippin, it's time.
You're going to be very proud of me, Father.
I will try not to disgrace you, sir.
Very well. Follow me.
Battles barbarous and bloody.
ain't seen nothing yet.
The gates of heaven away.
I killed at least 25 myself, Father.
Yes, yes. You and Pippin both did an excellent job. Well, now we rape and sack.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, it's required. And we also have to sing.
And then
singing
the
is essential to victory.
Marching out into
fall
the
to, men.
Conquering
eat,
the
drink,
enemy,
rape.
The day.
Give thanks to God for our
the
victory
blood
today.
Pounding in our ears. Jubilations, we can hear a grateful nation. Cheer!
I suppose it's a little late to wonder who this man was.
Well, it is a little late, but as long as you're interested, I am a common man, and this God, but a good man, a very good man.
You're also a very lucky man. You've had the privilege of dying for your king.
Please fail me.
Pippin! Why aren't you celebrating? You there, pick up this litter.
You know, of course, dying in a battle like this, you'll be going straight to Valhalla or wherever you infidels go, won't you?
Yes, the king has assured us poisonally. With all this bathing around, it's got me kind of edgy.
This wasn't your first battle, was it?
No, my fight.
Well, then maybe you could tell me. How did this battle compare with your other two?
Well, unless you get killed, one battle is pretty much like another.
I was afraid you'd say that.
Pippin, what are you doing? What's the matter?
I hope you get to Valhalla soon.
And I hope you get to heaven.
Oh, I will.
Pippin, this is embarrassing. A victory celebration and my own son not joining in.
Sorry, Father. You'll have to get used to victory celebrations without me. I thought there'd be more plumes. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky.
Well, I'll sing you a story of a soft lad. Had everything he wanted, didn't want what he had. He had wealth and pomp and fame and gave him all of that noise. He didn't have another horse in the joy. His life seemed purpose less and black. Unto that you don't feel like that. So he ran from all the things he'd done. He ran from things he'd just begun. He ran which is mighty fun to run. On into the country where he played as a boy. He knew he had to find him some simple toys. He wanted some place warm and free. Oh, we all could use a change of scene. The sweet summer evening, half wine and rain, sharing your supper. Simple joys ever, simple voices says, why not go ahead? And wouldn't you rather be a left-handed thief, a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea, than a man who never learns how to be free, not till he's golden dead? Sweet summer evening, no more lost sound, gaining a
still attractive. Charlemagne's mother, now living in the country where she enjoys those
sweet summer evenings at the fire sky.
Slab at the bottom of the sea, a newt on the root of a banyan tree, a fig on a twig in Galilee, than a man who never learns how to be free. Nothing the day, nothing the day, nothing, nothing, nothing the day.
Changed a bit.
No, Pippin, but you have. What have you been doing with yourself?
I went to war, Grandma.
Ugh. No wonder you look terrible. Men and their wars. Sometimes I think men raise flags when they can't get anything else up.
Grandma, sometimes you really say shocking things.
Well, I try. Oh, but Pippin, what's the matter?
I don't know, Grandma. I feel empty and vacant.
Empty and vacant? Young man, you listen to me. You're going to hear something very wise. Stop taking life so seriously. Just take things as they come along. Don't do so much thinking and don't do so much planning. There, how's that for advice so far?
Well, frankly, Grandma, it sounds pretty dull.
Huh. It'll sound better with music. When you are as old as I, my dear, and I hope that you never are, you will woefully wonder why, my dear, through your cataract and tar, you could squander away or sequester a drop of a precious year. For when your best days are yester, the rest are twice as dear. What good is a field on a fine summer night if you sit all alone with the weeds? Or a succulent pear if with each juicy bite you spit out your teeth with the seeds? Before it's too late, stop trying to wait for fortune and fate yours to cure all. For there's a one thing to be sure of, mate. There's nothing to be sure of. Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little from the world we're given. Time to take time, for spring will turn to fall in just no time at all.
But Grandma, it's time that I'm worried about.
Young man, you sit down and don't you say another word. I have three more choruses to sing. But you boys could sing with me if you'd like. And that goes for all of you out there in the audience, too. But just on the choruses, the verses are mine. Now, I never wondered if I was afraid when there was a challenge to take. And I never thought about how much I weighed when there was still one piece of cake. Now, maybe it's meant the years that I've spent feeling broken and bent and unwell.
where the shed begins. Roll these regal shoulders back and lift these noble chins. Give me a man who is handsome and strong, someone who's stalwart and steady. Give me a night that's romantic and long, and give me a month to get ready. Oh. Now I could wed lace to page you away and persuade them to play in a cranny. But it's hard to believe I'm being led astray by a man who calls me granny. Come on, boys, one more time. And let's hear it from everybody out there, too. Sabrina, a one, two, three, four. Woo!
Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a hit from the world we're given. Time to take time, for spring will turn to fall. Just no time at all.
Come on, y'all, I know it by now. Come on.
Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a hit from the world we're given. Time to take time, for spring will turn to fall.
Good works and good deeds are new laurels. But what could make you feel more obsolete than being noted for your morals? Here is a secret I never have told. Maybe you'll understand why. I believe if I refuse to grow old, I can stay young till I die. Now I've known the fears of 66 years. I've had troubles and tears by the score. But there's still one thing I'd trade them for. 67 more.
Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little more.
I'm gonna sing this one by myself. And I'm taking it center stage. Boy.
Come on, girl.
Yahoo! Oh, it's time to keep living. Time to keep taking from the world we're given. You are my time, so I'll bring on my show. And watching your friends be flung all over makes me feel young all over.
In just no time at all.
I remember that, Kevin. Woo!
She's absolutely right. It's time for me to start living and stop worrying. Maybe that's the secret. Just to enjoy all the simple things in life. The fresh air. The cool, clean water. The fresh fruit off of the... Fresh fruit. Oh, yes. And women.
Sex presented pastorally.
Of course. Women.
My days are brighter than morning air. Evergreen pine and autumn. But all my days were twice as fair if I could share my days with you. Excuse me. Nights are brighter than fire coals. Incense and stars and smoke bamboo. But nights were warm beyond compare. If I could share my nights with you tonight.
dreams to shine when I need the sun. With you to hold me when dreams are done. And my dearest love, that's right, if you take my love, then all my dreams are truly begun. And time weaves ribbons of memory to sweeten life when youth is through. But I would need no memories there if I could share my life with you.
I found it.
Two.
Thank you.
How do you feel now?
I feel empty and vacant. There's got to be something worthwhile I can do with my life.
Look, you just got started. There are plenty of things you can try.
Like what?
Like taking a look at this.
Good morning, peasants revolt, king slays thousands.
Hey, look at this.
Hi there. Peasants protesting rising taxes were slaughtered yesterday by Charlemagne's soldiers. The king warned that any further dissent would be treated in the same manner.
I can't believe that. My father would never slaughter people just for protesting. This can't be true.
Now, would a newspaper print anything that wasn't true?
Hi. Third mask here to bring new order from king. All political activity henceforth to be rigidly controlled.
My father can't just tell people what to think.
Why not? He's the king.
I don't care. People have the right to speak out freely.
There's no doubt about that.
Something's got to be done about it.
You're absolutely right.
We're surrounded by injustice and tyranny.
And prejudice. Don't forget about prejudice.
I'm finally beginning to see what my father really is. He forces people to fight and die over land that they couldn't care less about.
That's right.
I think it's time for a change.
It is time for a change.
We've got to dedicate ourselves to a better world for all people. The tyrant must be overthrown. Terror and bloodshed must be ended. We need a leader with the wisdom and the courage to sweep out the old order and bring in a new one. Down with Charles. Up with me.
Terrible. A son speaking out against his own father that way? I'd rather be drawn and quartered than to think that I had anything to do with what happened next. You see, after all, I'm just an ordinary housewife and mother, just like all you housewives and mothers out there. Word came back to me that Pippin was holding secret meetings of a treasonous nature.
Revolution!
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 Follow Pippin!
We pledge to stand by Pippin forever!
Forever!
Gentlemen, first let me say that I admire the dedication and the courage which has brought you here this evening.
Forever!
Thank you. Second, let me be honest about some of the dangers which may lie ahead. If during this insurrection any one of us is caught, the king's vengeance will be swift and terrible. You will undoubtedly be tortured. Broken on the wheel, cruelly maimed, even dismembered.
Forget that.
But I am sure that the prospect of these terrible agonies will not deter you in joining me. They may appear frightened now, but once the deed is done, once action against the king is taken, they will flock to my side. Maybe.
Mama, if Pippin kills father,
then you are next in line for the throne, darling.
But if father discovers Pippin's plot and executes him,
then you are next in line for the throne, darling.
Mama, no matter what happens, I'll move up.
Yes, darling. Back in my younger days, if things were going wrong, I might sob, I might pout. Now I learned if I just pitch in and do what's right, things will always work out. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, all could light a little fire, we all would be a little closer to our heart's desire. In fear of my beloved husband's safety, I decided to tell him about Pippin's activities. My lord, Pippin has been disloyal to you.
All sons are disloyal to their father at one time or another, my lady.
But Louis, Louis loves you, my lord.
Louis is an asshole, my lady.
Despite this rejection,
fashion, I took it upon my tiny shoulders the task of reuniting two men that I care for deeply. Lord knows we've seen enough troubles already. We've had our fill of gray skies. So put down the vinegar, take up the honey jar. You'll catch many more flies. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, all could think before we strike, we all better you feel after your yearly prayer.
I do. Don't talk.
I sought out Pippin. Pippin! Pippin, your father loves you!
Freedom and dignity for all men is more important than the love between one father and one son.
Still, your name will be on his lips when he prays next month at Arles.
He prays at Arles next month?
Alone. And unguarded.
Alone and unguarded. Mm-hmm. What date?
The 15th.
What time?
When the cock crows. Pippin, I beg you. I beg you, please bring this estrangement to an end.
I intend to.
Oh, Pippin, shall I tell your father of this resolve?
No. Let it be a surprise.
A surprise? Oh, isn't that sweet? Pippin, your actions make me very happy.
You've been a great help to me too, Fastrada.
Oh, what sweeter words a mother longs to hear. I know the parables told in the holy book. I keep close on my shelf. God's wisdom teaches me when I help others, I'm nearly helping myself. Spread a little sunshine on.
intrigue plots to bring disaster. The chapel at Arles.
It's all right, Father. You may come in.
I'm sorry to disturb you, my son. I know you like to pray alone.
You know who I am, then?
Of course, my son.
You want something from me, perhaps, then? Advancement? A favor?
No.
What then?
I am here to be with you for one moment. To touch you. To look in your eyes.
And what do you see?
Two eyes. A little cloudy with age. A sunset.
What else?
The death of thousands. The slavery of more, terror and bloodshed.
You see all that in my eyes.
Do you deny it?
Deny it? I'm proud of it. I brought order out of chaos. If slavery, blood, and death are a part of that, then so be it.
Those are words from the past. Time has passed you by, my son.
And your time has come, my son?
Yes, Father.
It's easy to judge the things I've done from where you stand. When I marched, the dust of the road was in my nose. And when I fought, the blood of the enemy was in my eyes. I sank in the shores on the mud on the Volga. I drowned two legions in the Vistula. Why, eagles, osprey, even vultures had a better view. From the heights, all things are clear. Birds float on the wind. But by God, I blew my breath across a continent, and I shaped an empire with it. Now, if you have no further business with me, go and leave me to my prayers.
What do you pray for, Father?
Strength. And may God give you the same.
Why won't my hand stop shaking? When all the earth is still, when ancient ghosts are waking, so many steps need taking, so many plans need making. I think I will. I think I will.
Your Majesty,
King Pippin.
Your Majesty.
Your Highness.
King Pippin.
King Pippin.
Morning glow, morning glow, starts to glimmer when you know winds of change are set to blow and sweep this whole land through. Morning glow is long past due.
I'm sorry, Father. I'll try to make a better world.
Morning glow, fill the earth. Come and shine for all your worth. We'll be present at the birth of old faith looking new. Morning glow is long past due.
think it's a little big. A
little tissue paper. We'll fix it right up.
King Pippin, Emperor of the Holy Roman Empire, is prepared to hear petitions.
Come ahead. You will all be dealt with fairly.
Sire.
My invitation extends to high and low alike.
Sire, I am a poor man.
You may stand. You may all stand.
Thank you, sire. I'm a very poor man. I can't find work. You have much and I have nothing. Is that fair?
No, that's completely unfair.
Treasurer! I order you to distribute money to the poor. King Pippin the Charitable.
Sire, I am a peasant, a simple working man. I own not one millimeter of land on which I've worked so hard all of my life. Is that fair?
No, that's terrible. But I will do something about it. I hereby decree that from now on all peasants will own the land that they cultivate.
King Pippin the Just.
Sire, now that you've given the land to the peasants, we loyal nobles have no source of income. Therefore, we can no longer pay taxes.
Well, then I hereby abolish taxes.
You realize, sire, without taxes, you'll have no money to support an army.
That's all right. I don't need an army. That's it. No more taxes, no more army.
King Pippin the Peaceful.
Sire, it is my duty to inform you that the infidel Hun has attacked in the east. He has destroyed 3 villages, raped hundreds of women, tortured and murdered thousands of your royal subjects.
Can he do that?
He has. But he will withdraw on one condition.
That seems very reasonable. I'm certainly willing to make any small concession. What's the condition?
He demands that your reproductive organ is separated from the rest of your body.
Well, then I guess you'll just have to go out and destroy the infidel.
Hooray! Hooray!
No!
Hooray! Hooray!
No!
Hooray!
No!
But sire, I have no more men to wage a campaign. I have no money to buy supplies. I have no army.
Excuse me a moment. Noble!
Yes, sire.
You remember that decree I made a little while ago about land and taxes?
Yes, sire.
That's off.
You mean you want me to pay taxes again and raise an army?
Yes, that's right.
But, sire, without land, I have no money nor power over the peasants.
You're absolutely right. I hereby suspend land reform.
Suspend land reform? Why the hell should I have to work while the poor gets handouts from the royal treasury?
That's a very good point. I hereby revoke charity to the poor.
I'm dying, sire.
Take that man away and hang him! No, stop, wait. Can I just think a minute, please?
Oh, Pippin, darling. Darling, you're doing a wonderful job. Nothing has changed since your father died. You're a natural ruler. Now, about my allowance. Let's
go. Deny!
Get out of my chapel, I want to pray.
Your chapel.
These are...
Pray? You're the king. What in the world would you pray for?
Strength.
How are you?
Hello.
So I hear you have become the king.
Yes, that's right.
Well, since you're the king and all, could you please put this back on my shoulders?
I'm sorry, I don't think I can.
Some king.
There are certain things I just can't do.
That's what they all say.
You don't understand, it's not that easy.
I knew you would be just like all the others. Mephlishka isn't the Michigan Republican.
Excuse me. Can I have my knife back, please?
Help yourself.
I'm sorry, Father.
Ah, it's all right. Only don't let it happen again.
Damn it! Nothing ever turns out the way I thought it would. I'm getting old, very old, and I still haven't done anything with my life.
You will. You will. You look frenzied. You look frazzled. He dares me out. Flushed and rushed and razzle dazzled. Dry your lips. Damp your scalp. Now I can see. A rut in disarray, and I'm not one to butt in, but in fact, I must say, if you take it easy, trust the wild dog look blue, don't look back.
Dedicated himself to the church. He sought God in the highways. He sought God in the byways. Then he finally cornered him in a huge cathedral. And what he found out was,
the church isn't saving souls, it's investing in real estate.
Many, when things get dank, will feel their grip. Go, we stay. Tranquil spirits high, pulse is low.
But what I've left behind looks trifling. What's ahead looks black. Am I doomed to spend my life lingering on?
Lingering on.
Just lingering on.
On lingering on.
I'll never find it! Never, never, never! Shit!
Easy, baby. You're on the right track. Santa Catherine. Enter Catherine!
I am so sorry. I couldn't get my eyelash onto my zipper. Was stuck.
Try one more time.
Oh, great.
Enter Catherine! Oh. A widow. The small boy and the large estate.
When I first saw Pippin, he was lying in the road like a discarded rag. Well, I would have passed him by. Perhaps I should have passed him by. But there was something about his foot. Yes, it was the arch of his foot that caught my eye. What I did was merely an act of Christian charity. After all, I had no idea that this discarded rag would clean up so well. There he was. He didn't know where he was. He looked so lost and exhausted. Now I have found that no man, no matter what his condition, can resist the charm of a small boy. So I sent my son Theo to him.
And to Theo, a small, lovable boy, and his large, lovable duck.
Pippin, Pippin, say hello to my duck.
How do you do?
Guess his name.
Augustus.
Wrong, his name's Otto. You're not very smart.
I am smart enough to know that a duck belongs in a pond and not in my bed.
Obviously hopeless. I had picked him up off the road. I could throw him back out again. Out he goes! Oh. Well, maybe I'll give him another chance. Pippin, you have been in this bed for 7 days. Now what is the matter with you?
Well, it's nothing that you could possibly understand.
Well, try me. Give me a chance.
All right. You see, I have an overwhelming need to be completely fulfilled, and it's never ever happened to me, so I am in abject despair.
And that's it?
Yes, that's it.
You may think what I did next was devious, scheming. Pippin, let me tell you something about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day he was struck by fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I felt that my life too was over. I was overcome by the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days. On the sixth day, I got up. There were things to be done, an estate to be run, a boy to raise. Well, look at that. I think he was really moved. Pippin. Pippin, this is such a large estate, and I'm all alone. I can't possibly do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
All right. All right, but just for a little while.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working, and slowly he became a part of everything, a part of our everyday life.
How often do we do this?
Every day.
Every day? Every day. That's exciting. Did you say something?
Oh, no. No.
I know that look. That's the look of a widow with a small boy in a large estate and nobody to sit at the head of the table.
For a long time, Pippin showed little enthusiasm for the work. But after a while, he showed no enthusiasm at all.
Keep up the good work, boys. What are you looking at?
Nothing. Nothing. Oh, Pippin, yes, there is something. The roof on the chicken house, it sprung a leak. If you could possibly look at it tomorrow.
Wait a minute.
Or the day after tomorrow.
The roof on the chicken house. I used to be the emperor of the Holy Roman Empire! All right, so I screwed it up. Still,
patching the roof and pitching the hay is not my idea of a perfect day. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. Now I'm not the type who loses sleep over the size of the compost heap. When you're extraordinary, you think about extraordinary things. That's the reason I'll never be the kind of man who dwells on how moths got into the tapestry or why the dungeon smells. Oh, it's hard to feel special. It's hard to feel big. Feeding the turtle and walking the pig. It's so secondary to someone who is very extraordinary like me.
The moat won't stop leaking, and the goat won't stop shrieking, and the griffin keeps losing his hair. If the West Wing is rotting and our best wine is clotting, well, I'm terribly sorry, but I don't care. I've gotta be someone who lives all of his life in superlative. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. The fact that I'm different, it's easy to see. So why doesn't anybody know it but me? I'm extraordinary. I need to do extraordinary things. Every so often a man has a day he truly can call his. Well, here I am to seize my day. If someone would just tell me when the hell it is. Oh, give me my chance and give me my wings. And don't make me think about everyday things. They're unnecessary to someone who is very extraordinary. Like me! I am! I am extraordinary! I am! That's it! I'm getting out! I'm leaving! Tomorrow.
And then Theo's duck got sick.
Pippin, Otto is sick.
Pippin, this is the first time he's come to you for help.
I'm sorry, Theo. I don't know anything about ducks.
Can you look at him, please?
Pippin, please.
Oh, all right. Let me have a look at him.
Now, say something hopeful.
This is a very sick duck. There's nothing I can do for him. Theo, wait a minute. Yes, there is. Come here. Come and kneel down here next to me, right over here.
It was like a painting, man and boy at prayer.
God, I know this is going to sound ridiculous, but this boy loves this duck. His breath has ebbed. His pulse is low. His feet are webbed, but even so, you must know that although our tears are poised to burst, we've kept our faith warm through the worst. We haven't lost our luck or run amok. To prayer we've stuck. Please reward our pluck and save this duck.
They prayed all day, and then, just after sunset, the duck died.
I'm sorry, Theo. We can go to the pond and get another duck. Why did the damn duck have to die?
And then an interesting thing happened. Theo was plunged into monumental despair while that prince of despair, Pippin, dedicated himself to raising the boy's spirits.
Theo! Hey, Theo, we're going out to thrash some grain right now and we need another good man. You want to give us a helping hand? Another time, maybe.
But Pippin showed remarkable persistence. When one thing failed, he tried another.
Theo! Hey, Theo! You want to be the tallest little boy in the world? Fee, fi, fo, fum! I smell the blood. Here, I made you a pair of stilts. Come on, I'll help you get up on them. You can be taller than anybody.
most men would have given up. But Pippin, with amazing perseverance, tried yet another way.
Theo, guess what I have for you this time? Don't turn around. I'm gonna bring it right down to you. Okay, when I count to three, you can turn around and open your eyes and look. Are you ready? One, two, three, look!
That's not a duck, dummy!
Did I say it was a duck? Yeah, you were a flop. Go on. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
No, no, it was my fault.
It was my fault. It's been a long time for me.
No, no, I just forgot. You know, I think...
Yes?
It'll be better.
Next time?
Next time. Listen, I think we're gonna skip this part. Not much really happens. A little of this, a little of that. Whole lot of that. But the season changed as it always does, and life was filled with those everyday things. Seeds to be sown, fences to be mended. Finally, of course, a love song to be sung.
Sitting on the floor and talking till dawn.
Candles and confidences.
Trading old beliefs and humming old songs.
And lowering old defenses.
Singing a love song.
La 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 la.
Love song. La 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 la. Private little jokes and silly pet names.
Lavender soap and lotions.
All of the cliches and all of the games. By themselves, now they don't mean much.
Together they send you reeling
into a love song.
La 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 la.
Love song. La 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 la.
close your eyes.
Why?
We've got a surprise for you.
We've got a surprise.
We've got a surprise. Now, keep your eyes closed, Pippin. No peeking.
I don't usually like surprises.
Oh, you're going to like this one.
Can I open my eyes now, please?
Not yet. Just a minute.
Now?
All right, now you can open them. Quince pudding flambé. Oh, I haven't made this in years, but I thought because it was a special occasion...
What special occasion?
Well, 6 months ago today you arrived here. So Theo and I thought we'd celebrate with this little party. I made you this, and Theo made you a flute.
Here.
Theo! Thank you, it's beautiful! I don't know what to say.
Well, let me say something then. In the 6 months since you've been with us, you've come to mean a great deal to me, to us, to our very everyday, ordinary lives. So I just want to say for me, for Theo, that we're very glad that you're here. Well, now that there are so many good years ahead of us, here you go. Well, isn't anyone going to eat my pudding?
I am.
I've got to get out of here.
Pippin, what's the matter?
I just have to go.
Pippin, I don't understand.
I need to leave.
Why?
Because this isn't enough. Life is more than ducks that die in leaking roofs and flaming quince pudding.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure, and I'm not going to be stuck doing the same damn thing every day.
And night?
Don't you see? There has to be something more than this. There has to be.
Well, maybe there isn't anything more.
I know there is.
I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day he was struck by fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I felt that my life too was over. I was overcome by deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days.
On the
sixth day, I got up. There were things to be done.
Gotta
find a stake to be run. A boy to raise. Could you hold that light a moment, please? Thank you. I guess I'll miss the man. Explain it if you can. His face was far from fine, but still I'll miss his face and wonder if he's missing mine. Some days he wouldn't say a pleasant word all day. Some days he'd scowl and curse, but there were other days when he was really even worse. Some men are heroes, some men outshine the sun, some men are simple good men. This man wasn't one, but still I'll miss his moods, his gloomy solitudes, his blunt, abrasive style. But please don't get me wrong, he was the best to come along in a long, long. Of his foot was really in a class by itself.
finally realized what we all knew from the start.
What's that?
That your search for perfection and fulfillment was doomed from the start.
That nothing ever turns out the way you expect it to. It's all flawed in one way or another.
Isn't that true?
Nothing's been completely fulfilling now, has it, Pippin? Has it?
No. I guess there's nothing.
Wait, there is something.
There is?
Yes.
What?
The only completely perfect act in our repertoire, the finale!
The finale!
When he does it, it's a trick, Pippin. But when you do it, it'll be for real.
When I do it?
Yes. You mean you want me to get into that thing and set myself on fire?
Yes. Wait a minute.
You will step into the flame, Pippin.
Become part of the flame.
Be engulfed by it.
Become the flame itself.
And for one moment, shine with unequaled brilliance.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the great Pippin in our never-before finale, seen on a public stage. Woo!
Stop that! Look, if this finale is so spectacular, why don't one of you do it?
Cute, Pippin, real cute. Look, we're just ordinary, everyday men and women. Just regular old people who keep this old world spinning. Hell, we're nothing. But you, Pippin, you're an extraordinary human being with extraordinary aspirations and dreams.
You deserve an extraordinary climax.
An unparalleled finale.
It's everything you've been looking for. Your dream.
Complete ultimate fulfillment.
Perfection, like the sun blazing in the sky.
The sun at its zenith. Think about the sun, Pippin. Think about her golden glance. How she lights the world up. Well, now it's your chance with the guardians of splendor inviting you to dance, Pippin. Think about the sun.
Look, it's just that if this isn't it, I'm going to have a tough time trying something else.
You lack a certain amount of poise, Pippin.
Of the radiance.
Remember the beauty.
Admiring glances.
Thunderous applause.
Think of the word of mouth.
Think about your life, Pippin.
Days are tame and nights the same.
Think about the beauty in one perfect flame.
More lights, perhaps.
You want more lights? Give this angel more lights.
Think about your life, and then think about the dreams you planned. Think about the moment that's so close at hand. With the power and the glory of heaven. Think about
giant bird that soars to the sea. And if I'm never tied to anything, I'll never be free.
What the hell are you doing here? Pippin? Pippin, where are you going? Pippin, stop all this nonsense and get on with it! The finale, Pippin!
The finale!
Coward!
Compromiser!
Compromiser!
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. I never came close, my love. We nearly came near. I think it was here, 'cause it never was there.
If this is the way you want to live, Pippin, you'll see what it's like without us. Take away the set. Out, everything. Take out the lights. Pinks, reds, out. Oh, not too flattering, is it now, Pippin? Costumes, someone get their costumes. And the makeup, all of it, off. Around, Pippin. How do things look to you now?
They showed me crimson, gold, and lavender, a shining parade.
A mole, Pippin. You want to spend the rest of your life with a woman with a mole?
A mole!
But there's no color I can have on earth that won't finally fade.
And the kid, the wine, 24 hours a day. Give me this, give me that.
Give me that.
No costumes, no makeup.
It never was here. I think it was there.
And no magic.
Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for our inability to bring you the finale that we had so promised. But it seems our extraordinary young man has elected to compromise his aspirations. But I know there are many of you out there, extraordinary people, exceptional people, would gladly trade your ordinary lives for the opportunity to do one complete act. And if you should choose to do so, we'll be right here, waiting. Whatever you want us. Why, we're right inside your heads. And we promise you sets, costumes, lights, magic, and a short but spectacular career.
Oh, yes, you in the green jacket. You in the green jacket. Why the perfect act? That green jacket by you. Blaze of glory and extraordinary climax.
Move it! Take out the rest of the lights. Orchestra, pack up your fiddles, get your horns, and go home. Take your damn hands off the keyboard. You try singing without music, sweetheart.
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much.
Pippin, do you feel you've compromised?
No.
Do you feel like a coward?
No.
How do you feel?
Trapped, but happy. Which isn't too bad for the end of a musical comedy. Ta-da! Alyssa, Jessica, Heather, Heather, Eddie, Daniel, Steven.
I need a letter to Layhouse Productions.